Uganda's education systems have been long faulted for doing little to solve the increasing rates of unemployment in the country. Experts say the system produces more job seekers than job creators. For this reason, the National Curriculum Development Center and other bodies decided to introduce a practical basis curriculum. Dr. Grace Bangsima says they are continuing to make amendments to the curriculum to make it more practical.
Century survival requirements require countries to gradually shift away from knowledge-based learning to skills and competencies, along with a focus on the core skills or soft skills. Effective curriculum implementation guarantees that Uganda continues to nurture and prepare her citizens to become dependable, skilled and knowledgeable human resources who will survive in the increasingly competitive global market. This goes with the issues of emphasizing currently of life skills and values. How do we nurture them? How do we assess them? How do we see that the person has got good attitudes to live, but also to be for others? So all those are encompassed in what we package as a curriculum for this.
Baguma adds that they've also been able to produce enough literature and textbooks of the curriculum, which they have spread to schools across the country.
For the need for the reforms in education are enshrined in the government white paper on education of 1992. The recommendations which have guided the reforms in curricula, in particular, in the recent past, have resulted in the review of the pre-primary curriculum, primary curriculum, secondary curriculum, which is still ongoing, and BTVET curricula, among others. Recently, the new competency-based lower secondary curriculum has been rolled out, and the center has now embarked on the process for the review of the A-level curriculum.
Of the learners in the lessons, and as all schools engage or use the learner-centered methods of instruction. So learners are not simply receivers of information, but they also participate in the teaching and learning process. So there is active involvement. And also, majority of the schools provided time for games and sports, because we also want to discover the talents of the learners and nurture them.
The government of Uganda introduced the thematic curriculum in 2003 to 2004 in all primary schools in Uganda. The aim of the thematic curriculum was to address the issue of the use of local language as a medium of instruction for teaching learners from primary 1 up to primary 3 in primary schools, and primary 4 will be the transitional year as English becomes the primary language of instructions from primary 5 onwards. NCDC also reveals that they have managed to train all teachers in court to equip them with knowledge on the thematic curriculum.
All the regions, and these master trainers are supposed to go on training the teachers in that region, and the teachers we train are also supposed to train their colleagues at school level. So the research found that majority of the teachers so far had been trained on the new lower secondary curriculum.
The thematic curriculum is premised on the belief that when children start their learning in their first language or mother tongue, they could learn more effectively and efficiently. They could also come to appreciate the English language better in the later years. Report by Sulaiman Motebi for the news.